Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how easy it is to set up your digital calendar using Mango Display. So the first thing you got to do is go to app.mangodisplay.com and log in. If you don't have an account, there's a quick sign up. You can just go through that process. So in this case, I'm going to log in. And once you log in, you want to add a new display. So you have a couple of options here. If you want to use a web browser, so you basically want to get a unique URL and use that on your PC, your Mac, Raspberry Pi, or smart TV, or anywhere else that you have a web browser, you can use this option. If you have a Fire TV or an Amazon Fire tablet or an Android tablet, you can use our app, Mango Display app, and go through the process. The setup process is pretty similar for both, so I'm just going to go through this so I can share the information with you as we go. So I'm going to select that one. I'm going to call it Demo Calendar. Okay, I'm going to put theme as modern. You can always change those themes later. To get started, let's just do that. All right, and right away you'll notice that it's created a Mango display URL for you. This one can be used, like I said, anywhere. So I'm going to just click out of this so we can see it right now within our new tab. We've got the clock set up there as a default widget. And then we're going to continue to configure it. So right now we have the clock. So the first thing you can do is move things around. You want to move the clock to the corner as an example. You want to resize it. You can resize all of that. And it's saving. And as soon as it saves, you'll notice that it gets flipped over here. So the clock is now moved over to the left. And to start adding widgets, let's go through the process. So you click on the plus and then you click on calendar. If you are not subscribed, you might need to subscribe. And then we want to basically connect our Google account to Mango Display. So we go add Google account. I'm going to choose the demo calendar that we have. I'm going to confirm. Okay, and once that's done, you'll get back to the screen and it shows you that your account is now added. And you can click on the account and see all of the calendars that you currently have under that account in your Google Calendar account. So to start now, I'm just going to leave maybe two of them on. I'm going to deselect this and leave the school schedule and the events on. And then we go into settings. And here is where you have many different options that you can choose. So let's start with the list. So the first thing we want to do is enable the widget. And then we're going to choose list. We're going to say five events. We're going to leave the defaults on to start. And then we're going to leave it as off. I'm going to save it. So it puts the widget right onto the screen. I'm going to say I want to, so let's see it to left. Let's do that. Okay. And then once it saves here, you should see how it looks as well. There you go. We got some test events in there. I'm going to go here and modify it and also set some scrolling. So I'll do 10 suggest. If you were running out of space, as an example, and you wanted to scroll, you can have it set to scroll, right? So it can show you all of the different events in a scrolling frame. So if you want to make this smaller and add news as an example, right, you can do that as well. So I'm just going to add five events of news, save it, and put that down here. Just to show you a few of the options, right? So as soon as that saves, you see the news has gone down and then you have a scrolling. Okay, so that is the list events. And then let's go in and let's start to see the schedule events. So let's do schedule. I want to see current day. I want to tell it when my start and end date is, my start and end time. And I want to see current week. You know, I can give it details like when my week starts to show me events, locations, show titles, example. So I'm going to hit save on that. You know, obviously, I want to make this like a full screen so we can see what's going on. And then once that saves, you'll see that it's filled out the full screen. So this is basically like a schedule view that you would see on a regular work calendar as an example. It's got your time on the left, and it's got your blocks within the column dates. Okay, and then we can choose monthly views. So monthly view, you can choose to, you know, keep it 6 week always or 4, 5, or 6 based on the month. I'll leave that as the default. You can choose, you know, when the week starts. You can choose to hide the weekends, and you can show the month name as well. And one cool thing about this is that we can also display special events, and you can click on it to learn more. But let me show you first how it looks without the events. Right, so this is how it looks without the events. Okay, and I'm going to add without the photo events. So now I'm going to make one of the calendars, which I know I have some photos on, as a photo calendar. So for example, on the shift schedule, or let's go to the family events one. Okay, and let's make that. Let's save that as a photo calendar. And I think I have some here as well. So I'm going to make that the photo calendar. And basically all it is that you're just adding images to your events, and we have the logic that would pick it up and then show it to you on your calendar. Okay, so let's see how it looks. And there you go. So you've got things like GIFs that you could use. So you can see them moving around on birthdays, on anniversaries, things like that. It's going to just show you all of that information here. And also the cool thing about the month is that, you know, sometimes due to the fixed height of these cells, you may have more events, but you'll notice that every 5 seconds, it actually switches and shows you the remainder of the events. So you're not actually losing any events. You're getting to see all of them here. They keep switching every 5 or 10 seconds, right? So you get full visibility into your calendar. But I think these images are really cool, right? And if you don't set it up correctly, you'll get a no access image. So you'll know that you haven't given permissions for it. So that's why that is there. So it's easy for you to say, oh, okay, that image is not given the right permissions on my Google calendar event. So I got to fix that. And then that should be fine. All right. And then the last piece is on weeks. So you might want to see 2, 3 weeks, you know, upcoming 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Let's do 3 weeks. And let's see how that looks. Okay, and I'm refreshing it here just because I'm on different tabs. Otherwise, it'll refresh automatically. So here you go. Here's the 3 weeks, right, with all of your events listed. So you're never going to be missing any events at all. And this can be added with any backgrounds that you want to use. You know, we can use Unsplash backgrounds as an example. Right, so let's turn on some Unsplash backgrounds of nature. That's good. Nature, night sky is always good. And then you can also affect themes. So I went go for modern. Usually, if you have a background, you want to go with something that has sort of a white text on it, makes it look a little bit better. So let's see how this looks now. There you go. Okay, you can also change things like the background settings on it, right? So you can go back in here, and if that you couldn't see too well on that, you can go, okay, format, I want to make this you know, a little bit darker, right? And so you can actually see that it's a lot better and easier to see. So that's just an overview of the calendar. I mean, there's obviously a lot of things that you can do with it, you know, play around with different settings and get it to display exactly the way that you want it. If you have any questions, you know, feel free to chat with us from your account. You can always chat with us using the chat button right there, right? And we usually get back to you pretty quick, depending on what time it is. We'd love hearing from you. Thank you.